Hello students, in this class we'll see the uses of if condition. Although we have already discussed what is if condition and that is uploaded in YouTube. You can find those videos in the playlist Java programming. Go and find it in the Java programming. Lot of videos are there which will clear every concept regarding if condition. And in this class we'll see the uses of it, casual uses of if conditions. What are the situations, places where if conditions can be used? So I'll show you a few examples, and with the help of those few examples, you get the idea that how to use it. So let us make a program. Use if. Let me make a program which will here, we'll take one example of profit and loss. Okay. So let me first type the program and then I'll explain what this profit and loss kind of thing can be done with the help of if condition. So here is a program, dear students. And in this program, we have made to find out whether it is a profit or a loss. For this, what we have done, you can see a complete program here. You can pause the video and you can type it. And now see this. CP is for cost price, SP is for selling price. A scanner in for inputting a message into the cost price. And we are inputting to the CP variable, whatever the cost price of item is, and then the selling price of it. And now till here it is just input. What we are doing here, now this is the way if condition is used. What kind of if condition it is? It is simple if condition. This kind of if condition is known as if and only if. This is one of the if condition. This is another if condition. This is another if condition. How it is working? Let me explain it. So this is the block of the if condition. Always remember, in some cases we do not give the block, and in those cases it is like if you want to execute only one statement, then we do not need to give any block. As in this case also, we have to execute only one statement in case this condition is true. We could either remove these blocks, we can remove it, but it's always good to have it. But in case you are sure that you have to execute only one statement, then you can remove the block. In that case, only one statement just after the if condition will be the part of if condition. After that, it will be out of the if condition. But the block makes it very sure and clear that yes, whatever thing is inside the block are the part of if condition, and those statements or those instructions will be executed when this relational expression will give the result in true. If it will be true, then only it will execute. So let us see whether it is true or false. So that depends on the value that we'll provide to it. Okay, so let us execute it. We have compiled it. Once again compiled, no problem. Now run it. Joseph. Enter cost price. Let us enter the cost of the price, cost of an item, rupees 50. Enter the sale price. I purchased something at rupees 50 and I'm selling it to 55. In this case, it's a profit. This is a profit. Fine. Let us run the program again. Suppose we have purchased something at 50 and it's sold, had to sell it in 45. It's a loss because we have sold. Now, which is doing this? This condition is executing. In this first case, when CP was 50 and SP was 55, then what happened? It checked this whether, look at the first condition first, where the CP is 50 and SP is 55. If CP is greater than SP, this time CP is 50 and SP is 55. So this became false. CP is not greater than SP, no? This became false. So this block didn't execute it. Now it checked this. If CP is less than SP, CP is 50, SP is 55. Cost price is less than this case. So this became true. So these things, although it is only one thing, but inside the block, a lot of things may be there. So it's a profit. Because of this, this profit message came. And when we executed, one more thing. Remember this point. You have to remember this point. This condition will also be checked. Yes, this condition will also be checked because this is if and only if. They all the ifs, this if or this if, they all are independent. They all are independent. All the if conditions will be checked. Even if this is true or this is true, then also it will be checked. But yes, after checking it, it will be found that they are not at all equal. So it will not be executed. Once again, let us give the equal cost 50 and 50. No profit, no loss. Because this time, this condition is true. And so this is getting executed. So this is a very simple example of if and only if. Like this, you can have any number of if condition you can give. Any number of if condition. So this was one example. Let me make this program in a different way. Okay, you look at this program. You can re or forward the video to look at this program because I'm going to erase it and modify it to have something new in it. So this time what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you if and else, if and else, simple if else. Okay, simple if else. There are mainly three versions of if condition. Simple if and only if, which is this. Another is if and else. And after that, if, else. And nested if is also there. So we'll see them one by one. So if cost price is greater than selling price, then say it's loss. Else what? Else, say profit. In earlier case, it was given, the condition was given for every single condition. Means if this will be the case, then do this. If it is less than, then do this. If it is equal, then. But in this case, we are telling that if this condition become true, then tell this. And if this condition become false, then what to do? Then this has to be done. This else means if the given condition is getting false, then this will be executed. So let us check it out. First, save it. And cost price 85.96 or anything. It's 9. It's loss. Why? Because 85 is greater than selling price. When the cost is greater than sell price, that's loss. Run it another time, and this time 45 and 63. It's a profit because this time what happened? CP is not greater than SP. This 45 is not, so this condition became false. And else means otherwise. If this is true, then do this. Otherwise, do this. So this is if and else. If else. This is the second version of if condition. Okay. Now I'm going to show you the third version of if condition. Okay. So watch it carefully and then pause it or do whatever. And then I'm resetting it to the previous version by pressing Ctrl Z. Yes, this was our program working fine and nice. So this time I'll do something else if. Or else you not need to, actually let me complete it first. So this is another case. Save it, run it. Due to Control Z, this has happened, I think. The cost price 45 and 63. It's a profit. How it is working? Let us have a look. You enter the value of cost. Cost price is 45. Selling price is 63. So when it checked this, cost price is greater, it became false. When it became false, it came to the next condition. Is or if CP is less than SP, this time CP is less than SP. This became true and this is executed. And after that, what happened? After that, it came, just it left other conditions. It left all other conditions. Okay? ये सारा बाकी conditions को छोड़ देता है. जब हम लोग if and only if use कर रहे थे पहला version, you can go back and see where else was not written. Then every if condition was checked. But in this case, when we connect, this is also called if else ladder, where every condition is connected with each other, with this else. This is causing or forming the connection factor between them. And what does this do? Is do that if any one of the condition is matched, or if any of the condition is found true, then that is executed and rest all are left. They are not checked. It saves the processor's time by just restricting it from checking uselessly the other conditions, which was not there in if and only if. The only difference, not only difference, but the one of the major difference between if and else if is if and only if. If you are using if, which was our first case, all the if conditions are checked. Even if the first condition, your work is done, no matter. All the condition will be checked. The processor will check all the conditions. If you have given 100 conditions, think it like if you have given 100 conditions, then what? If you have given 100 conditions, then even if your condition is met in the second place, second condition met, your work is done, then also all rest 98 conditions will be checked if you are using if and only if. But in case if you are using if, else if in this way, then what will happen? If the first condition is matched, rest all the condition will be left, thus saving the processor's time and overall your time or overall processing time is saved. So although we have not many condition in this case of profit of loss, profit and loss, we have not many conditions. Only three conditions: either it will be profit, either it will be loss, or it will be no profit, no loss. Okay. So let us run it and see. This time, let us have no profit, no loss. Then it found this false, and this true. यहाँ पर हम लोग और क्या कर सकते हैं? यहाँ पर condition देने का भी ज़रूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि ये scene ही ऐसा है, scenario ऐसा है कि ये बड़ा होगा cost, if its cost CP will be greater, then what has to be done? If it is less, then what has to be done? If it is not greater, not less, then what? Then of course it is equal. That not need to be specified, which we had specified. So only having else will resolve the problem. Let us have a look. Save it. Compile it. For few of you, this might be a little confusing, but no need to get confused. Be clear. It's no profit because this condition also not matched. This also didn't match. So else, in all other cases, in case it is not greater, CP is not greater, it's not smaller, then in all other cases, but only one case is there, it may be equal. It will be only equal. If it's not greater or not less, then it will be equal. So for this, these cases or for other all cases, this is like this. So we may make a modification in this program to just make the point very clear. So in this class, I'd like to just tell you this much only about if condition. Although these things have been extensively discussed in my one more video, you may watch it for more details. So thank you for this class.